Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to discuss the differences between a product design interview and a system design interview. Nowadays, many tech companies are asking product design interviews to software engineering candidates. Such companies include Meta, previously known as Facebook, etc. Most candidates do not understand the differences between a product design interview and a system design interview, and thus they perform poorly in their product design interviews. But before going further, I would like to welcome if you are new to my YouTube channel. Right now, almost 80% of my viewers are not my channel subscriber. So I will really appreciate that if you are watching my YouTube video, then please do subscribe this channel. It will help the YouTube algorithm and it will actually put my YouTube channel in front of more audiences. Of course, if you want to keep your unfair advantage that you have because of watching my YouTube videos in interviews, then maybe you don't subscribe to the channel. But I would say if you want to help others as well, then please do subscribe to this channel so that YouTube algorithm also push my videos to more viewers like you. First, we need to understand why many tech companies are now asking product design interviews for software engineering candidates. In the past, the product design interviews were only meant for product managers and product owners. However, companies are now realizing that coming up with a product design is not just a job of a product manager or a product owner. There are many stakeholders who are involved in designing a product, and software engineers are one of them. They are involved as much as in the product design as product managers or product owners, or even sometimes more, especially if you are a staff software engineer or an architect. As a software architect or technical leader, you are not only responsible for solving how to design a product, but you are also responsible for shaping the product itself and the future direction of the product. Now let's see what are the differences between a product design and a system design, and what are main areas to focus in each of these design interviews. Now let's discuss the differences between a product design interview and a system design interview in a tabular form. So in product design interview, the main focus is on what and why. That is what is the problem statement and the vision for the product to solve the problem and beyond. So the main focus is what you are trying to solve and why. Whereas in system design interview, the main focus is on how. That is how to implement certain features or how to solve certain requirements of a product or a system. In a product design interview, a candidate is supposed to discuss the product requirements in greater detail. And the candidate is supposed to discuss every possible aspect of the requirements. In case of system design interview, the candidate is supposed to discuss the minimal set of requirements to create a viable product. In product design interview, the candidate is supposed to prioritize the product requirements into different phases and put the requirements in P0, P1, P2, etc. and discuss the reasoning behind the priorities. Whereas in a system design interview, the candidate is supposed to prioritize the product requirements into must-have and good-to-have. So must-have are those requirements which the candidate is supposed to solve in the interview, and good-to-have are those requirements will not be the main focus of the system design interview. In product design interview, the candidate discusses the customer impact in greater detail. However, in a system design interview, the candidate only touched the customer interaction at a high level. In a product design interview, the candidate may discuss the APIs exposed by the product system in a greater detail. In a system design interview, however, the candidate only discusses the main APIs exposed by the system, and usually only if it's asked by the interviewer. In a product design interview, the candidate discusses how the product system will be evolved with changing requirements or evolving market. In a system design interview, the candidates usually don't discuss the future roadmap. In a product design interview, the candidates usually don't go into discussing the architectural implementation of the system or the product. Whereas in a system design interview, the candidates discuss the overall architecture of the system along with going deeper into architectural designs and trade-offs of individual components or microservices, etc. Now we will discuss the differences between the product design interview and a system design interview with an example. And the example is that suppose in an interview you are asked to design a payment gateway service such as Stripe. So in a product design interview, the main focus will be on the following things. The product design interview will deal in greater detail with what is the problem that the Stripe is solving and what are the scenarios where a payment gateway service is needed. The candidate is supposed to discuss what are different ways the problem can be solved, and the candidate is supposed to discuss what are different pros and cons of each approach. For example, the main problem that Stripe is solving is enabling third-party merchants to charge their customers without being involved in the financial transactions so that they don't need to be PCI IDSS compliant. By the way, if you want to know more about Stripe product design, you should check my previous video on Stripe system design, the link for which you can find here. The product design interview will discuss the interaction that the Stripe system will have with the customer. For example, what are different ways to enable merchant to charge their customers without requiring the merchants to be PCI IDSS compliant? One way is to enable a checkout mechanism in which a merchant is never involved during the checkout process and is not collecting any customer financial information. Now there are multiple ways to enable this. One mechanism is redirection, which is used by PayPal, and other mechanism is what Stripe does. Then the product design delve into discussing what if there are merchants who need to be involved in the checkout process for some reason, or if there are scenarios where the merchants are providing the customer financial information to Stripe payment gateway. Then what should be done to support such scenarios? This is something that may not be discussed in a traditional system design interview. The product design will discuss all the different possible customer interactions in greater detail. For example, let's consider a checkout scenario. In a product design interview, the candidate will discuss what is the checkout experience, what would happen if something fails. For example, the transaction does not go through due to credit card getting declined. How different card authentication mechanisms such as 3D Secure, etc. will be integrated with the checkout process, etc. At the same time, how the merchant will interact with the product. Whether we would like to notify the merchants whenever an event happens, such as sale, order, completion, or a failure. In a product design interview, the candidate is also supposed to prioritize the requirements, that what are P0 requirements, what are P1 requirements, what are P2 requirements, etc. For example, charging a customer credit card could be a P0 requirement, but fraud detection could be a P1 requirement in that case. Since the customer interaction is an important focus area for product design interviews, the candidates sometimes are asked to actually discuss the UX experience and how the customer will be using the product. Since the product design interview focuses on overall product behavior, so the application programming interface is also one of the main focus area for the product design interviews. Here I would like to mention one thing is that the way these tech companies are conducting the product design interview for software engineering candidates is a bit different from the way the same product design interview is conducted for product managers or product owners. Usually the API design is only part of the product design interviews for software engineering positions. Now finally, while we are designing a payment gateway service such as Stripe, in a product design interview, the candidate is not supposed to discuss the overall architecture of the system. And it's not supposed to discuss what are different microservices and how those microservices will be interacting or how those microservices will be implemented. This is the main focus area of system design interviews. So I'm going to stop the video here. I hope you find this video useful and it removes some of the confusion that you have between what are the differences between a product design interview and a system design interview. And if you find this video useful, I will really appreciate if you like the video and also add a comment below. And also, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, then please, please, please do subscribe to this channel. It will help this channel a lot. Thank you and take care.
Hi guys, remember to hit the bell button and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Thank you. Now.